One of the things you should be doing before you go to the job interview is do that thing I said about going to payscale.com or glassdoor.com and having an idea of the average price for someone with your education, skills, and abilities, okay? So you have some idea of your worth. So if you know that on average, people pay someone in your position with your background, let's say 100, okay? And these people are offering you 30, I mean, you would know that that's an obvious lowball, like a ridiculously low amount of money. You know that, that you're worth more than that, okay? But like I said, employer behavior is going to be to try and get you for as little as possible, okay? They're going to say and do a whole bunch of different things to convince you that you're only worth this much and that you should take the job for this much. They'll say things like, well, you know, we don't pay more than that for, like, you know, more than 30 for this position. They'll say that. It's a lie. They'll say that, well, you know, if you don't take it, I've got somebody else, you know, coming along in 5 minutes that will take it. That also is probably a lie. They'll say, no, you're not worth this. You know, the average price for someone with that is not 100, it's 30. That's a lie. Like, they'll say all kinds of things to get you to accept the job for a low amount of money and be satisfied with it, okay? That's the thing. You have to expect that, okay? You have to stay in the game long enough till they start to see your value and they see what you could bring and why they should hire you. And if you've done that correctly and luck is on your side, you will get to the final round where they then offer you a job, okay? And only then is the time to start really thinking about how much you want to work for. Until you get to that point, you have nothing to bargain with. So whatever they, if they bring up pay and they say, well, we can only pay you this, you know, you say things like, well, you know, that could work, you know? Right? You know, I mean, you don't want to commit to something really low, but you don't want to disqualify yourself. So the secret is to get to the end. Once you're at the end, they offer you the job, then you can say, this is great. I'll give you this, but I need this pay. Scratch out that number and write in this number and you got a deal. Right? And, you know, if you're absolutely desperate for a job, like I said, you can't really negotiate if you only have one option. If you know your worth and you're applying to a lot of places, maybe you got this job offer rather quickly, you can get others, or you're pursuing several opportunities at once, you know, then you have options and then you can negotiate.